Hey, and welcome back to another Darkfall tutorial. So today we're going to be doing this sci-fi sort of audio visualizer, as you can see in the example here. So as you can see, I'm in Cycles Render. So we're going to go ahead and set up a quick scene. If you press numberpad 1, then Control Alt numberpad 0, you can align the camera to the front view. We can just drag this in a little bit closer. Then, so let's go ahead and add in the sphere, Shift A. Go to UV sphere. And before we do anything, if we press T to bring up the sidebar here, we can scroll down and we want to generate UVs. This will automatically unwrap this sphere for us. Saves us doing that. So now we have this, we can scale it up if we want to. And then since we've scaled it up, we need to apply the scale. So hold Control and press A. And we just want to apply the scale. Now we can see the faces are flat, so let's press T again. Should just smooth these. Now we can go ahead and add a modifier. So go to the Modifiers tab. We first want to give this a subdivision surface modifier. We can just increase the views to 2 if you want to, but you don't have to. So now go ahead and add the displace modifier. We're going to add a couple of these, and you can add as many as you want, depending on what kind of effect you're trying to go for. But I would play around with these and just try them out and see what sort of effects you get. So first thing we need to do is press new to add a new texture. The texture coordinates, we need to change this from local to UV. And since we've already kind of unwrapped it already, we've already generated UVs, we can select this here, select the UV map. Now we need to go ahead and create the texture. So we can click this button here, which will just take us over to the texture panel. So if you have an image you want to go ahead and load in, you go ahead and open that. But for this example, I'm going to use the built-in textures. So for this first one, I'm going to use marble. Again, playing around with these different procedural textures will give you a different result, so keep that in mind. So I just want to reduce the contrast. So maybe 0.3 for now. We can always come back later on and change these values if we need to, just to see how it looks. But for now, I think that's good. Go back to the modifiers panel. Then we just close this down for now. Add a new modifier, displace. Same thing as before. Select UV. Select the UV map. Select this button here. For this one, I'm going to use a clouds texture. And I'm going to increase this. Looks okay. If you want to play around with the scale and the size of things, you can do that here. But let's say that's okay for now. Go ahead and add in a third displace modifier. It's kind of looking crazy, but let's just do this. Change it to UV. Add the UV map. Let's select the texture. For this one, I'm going to use a distorted noise, I think. That's kind of crazy. So we need to reduce this a lot. Try that again. Okay, so now we've set these modifiers up, we want to move them around. And the way we're going to do that is baking the sound of an audio file to this. So let's go ahead and do that now. So if we select up here and drag this down, we can split the window. And I want to change this window to the graph editor. We're going to be doing these one at a time, so I'm just going to close these down. And I'm also going to mute them so we can't see them. So this is our first displacement modifier. And before we do anything, we need to go down here to the keying slot and just change this to delta scale. Go over to strength. So make sure your cursor is hovered over this strength. If we press I on the keyboard, it's now added a keyframe. You can see that it's done it up here as well. So now what we can do with this strength, we can go down to key. Then we can go to bake sound to F curves. So now we need to go ahead and select the audio. So the audio that I'm using, thanks to Digital Down for letting us use this. So I'll throw a link in the description. Definitely go and check out his YouTube channel. But now we can go ahead and select our audio. And we're going to do a couple of things. We have the lowest frequency and the highest frequency. The other values we don't really need to play around with unless you really want to. So go ahead and play with these values and see if you get something quite different. So this first displacement modifier, the lowest frequency is going to be 0. And the highest it's going to go to is 350. Again, these values is something I've found works for this example. For different audio files, it definitely will be different. But for this example, 350, that looks fine. Let's bake these sounds to F-curves. As soon as we've done that, this straight line has now turned into this bumpy graph. And if we play through, we can see the texture is distorted. But before we do the others, it's nice to hear the music as this plays along, so we can do that now. If you change this from the graph editor real quick to the video sequence editor, and then what we can do if we scroll out, Shift A, go to Sound, select this audio clip that we've already used. There we go. As you can see, the audio clip lasts longer than our timeline, so what we can do if we press N while hovered in this window here, we can see that the length is 3210, so let's just copy this by pressing Control C. Go down here to the end frame, press Control V. Now our timeline matches the length of the audio. So if we play through this, we can hear it and we can see it. I'm not sure if the audio comes through from this screen capture. It's the first time I've tried to play audio through this capture. So that's the first one done. Let's change this back over to the graph editor. Let's close this one down. Make sure we activate the visibility on this one here. Again, make sure we're on the first frame. We don't want to add a keyframe halfway through the clip, so just make sure you always jump back to the first frame. Press I to add a keyframe whilst hovered over strength. Now we need to make sure we only select the new strength here. We don't want to select this one too, because otherwise it will rebake it with the new values. So make sure we select the new strength. Go to key. Bake sounds to F-curves, and this time we want the lowest to be 350. And the highest, so this one can be quite high. Again, play around with these values. It will look a lot different depending on what values you use in your songs. Again, each song will be different, so keep that in mind. So now we select this. So now the second displacement modifier, it kind of displaces it as well, which looks pretty good. Let's go ahead and do the last one real quick. Make sure we enable visibility. Make sure we're on the first frame. Press I to add a keyframe. Select the strength, go to key, bake sounds to F-curves, and this one's going to be real simple, 50,000, 200,000, try that again, there we go. So now if we play this through, kind of see the frames dropping a bit, and that's because there's quite a lot going on, there's quite a few faces on this now moving around. Things might not match up for the music and the action. If that does happen, what you can do, if you go down here to playback, and you can AV sync, click that. That will help things play smoother. So now we've got the motion done, we can go ahead and just finalize a few things. What I did do is just set up a quick background, change this to the node editor. You see on the background here, this was from the last tutorial, the Omega particle, if anyone followed that. Change this to the world properties. I added a noise texture. These are the values I used. I added a mix node and changed it to multiply, just plugged it into the background. Or you could use a HDR image if you want. Just go ahead and set yourself up a background. For the materials, it's again very, very simple. We select new, just go to diffuse, change this to principal shader. So make sure the roughness is at 0. I'm going to change this color to black. And that's it. Very, very basic material setup. You could take this further and add some more grunge to it or make it look a lot better, but for this example, I think it looks fine. Let's just get rid of this since we don't need it. Let's give that a render, see how it looks. So it's not looking too bad. If we change this to the scene tab, go ahead and add some blur, a background, a few other little things. So all I did here was just brighten a few things up, maybe added a little bit of a glow, added a background, and then just added a few little color grading things. It's all very basic stuff you've probably done before. So now you're ready to go ahead and render this out. You want to make sure that you set the output. Go to where you want to save this to. Also, you can go ahead and change the samples if you need to. Then we want to go ahead and choose a file format. If you want to render this as a JPEG or a PNG sequence, you can go ahead and do that. But I'm going to render this as a video file, so choose FFmpeg video. Go down to encoding. We want to select presets. I'm going to choose H.264 in MP4 format. And then since we've got audio, we need to go down to audio codec, and I'm going to use MP3. So you can scroll back to the top and go ahead and hit animation. So hopefully you enjoyed this tutorial, or at least found it helpful. If you did, be sure to give it a like. If you create something cool, be sure to go to the Facebook group and post your images there. As always, thanks for watching. See you next time.